Welcome to Cruising Authority at cruisetalkshow.com. I'm your host, Barry Vaudrin. Well, we don't have very many ships in Minneapolis, so every once in a while I get on the lake in a boat and just have a good time enjoying the sun and the water. Well, I hope you enjoy this video that I made of the SS Norway. Welcome to the show. Pictured here is my prized photo of the SS Norway. She was a beautiful ocean liner built originally as the France. Sadly, she has been scrapped on the beaches of Alang, India. However, her memory lives on with those who had the privilege of spending time on board throughout her 40 years in existence. Over the years, I visited the Norway many times, and I even got to cruise the Caribbean aboard her one time just after her new decks were added. I wanted to put this video together because in 2000, I visited the Norway and took some video footage while I was on board as a visitor. That was the last time I had a chance to see her before her deadly boiler explosion about 3 years later, which also ended her career. I made a special effort to go see the Norway just after cruising aboard the brand new Zaandam with Holland America Line out of Fort Lauderdale. This was the Zaandam's christening ceremony, and then she went on a short cruise to Holland America's beautiful private island. When the Zaandam departed Fort Lauderdale, I was thrilled to see the ocean breeze follow us from behind. The ocean breeze used to be the Azure Seas, which was the first ship I ever cruised on out of Los Angeles. She actually was built originally as the Southern Cross. Sadly, this fine ship is gone too. Well, let's get on with my short visit to the Norway. Wow, this ship truly was a sight to see next to the pier in Miami. She looked massive, even though the ships today are much larger. I think what really set her apart was that she was built as an ocean liner, so she had that bigger-than-life look to her. I have fond memories of visiting the Norway. In the early years when she truly was the largest cruise ship in the world, she looked so powerful and graceful docked in Miami. And I think NCL darkened her paint job over the years because I seem to remember her royal blue paint being a bit brighter. In fact, just after her conversion to the Norway, she looked like a shiny new ship with her brilliant paint scheme. Here's what Bill Miller had to say about the SS Norway.
The SS Norway was a pioneer ship, which I did several cruises, and I crossed to Europe in it as the France, when it had this incredible image. It was so, she was like the Normandy, the greatest of liners, reincarnate in the 60s and 70s. But to go back aboard her as the Norway, she was saved in 1979-80, and she was the first mega cruise ship, so she was innovative. And she also proved not only that large 2,200-bed cruise ships had a future, remember we didn't have 70,000-ton cruise ships in those days. She proved that a big liner could operate year-round, that people would want to go to the Caribbean, say, and leave the hot and humidity of the Northeast and go to the hot and humidity of the Virgin Islands in July. She proved that you could run a seven-day cruise year-round. And she was the innovator, the great, she today, in retrospect, would be the great queen mother of cruise ships, the godmother of what we have today. She showed that big liners had a future, they had a role, that number of people could be accommodated. She also showed that infrastructure had to be organized purposely, like having large tenders so everyone could get ashore in an hour and not in 4 or 5 hours. She introduced shopping arcades and leisurely dining and a multiplicity of events on board. She was outstanding in so many ways, and I yes, I'm sad that she's gone, but I want to say that she's left such a great legacy. She had a great life. She sailed for 45 years. Not bad for a great liner.
This is a new sports bar. They took out Checkers Cabaret and they put in a sports bar. Hello, how are you?
Excellent.
Okay, here we go. Going into Club International. Club International on the Norway. The room has not changed too much. Okay, it looks like they put a new decking here on the Norway. They took out the wood and put this new material down. There's the great outdoor restaurant. And there is the grandeur of the seas. Okay. Well, it looks like they put down some plastic kind of a decking here. Well, it looks like they've done some nice things to the carpeting. They've added some new artwork in the stairwells and new artwork.
I had the opportunity to cruise on the SS Norway in the early 90s with a buddy of mine. We had a great time on that cruise to the Eastern Caribbean. These are some video clips from that cruise. I even made my way up into the forward engine room to explore a bit. I love the engineering aspects of the ships, particularly a steam-driven ocean liner like the SS Norway. The forward engine room was not operating at the time, but it was still fascinating. Next, my buddy and I climbed up inside of the crow's nest of the SS Norway. You have to hear this as we were about to climb through the little hole up into the mast.
That's the ladder we have to go up. Pretty intense, huh?
Right.
Here we go.
Okay, that's a small hole. You need to be able to fit through that.
Into the crew. We're on the top of the crow's nest almost.
What an incredible perspective from up there on the mast high above the superstructure while at sea. I took a few photos and video, and then we got down and went to dinner. On another trip in the mid-80s, I visited the Norway in Miami, and I hired a helicopter to fly me around the ship as it was departing. What an amazing experience that was to see this great ship from that perspective. got some great pictures and some unique angles from up there. I can't even count how many times I have visited the Norway, but I treasured every chance I had to visit this grand ocean liner. Well, thanks for tuning in to the show today. I hope you enjoyed it. Until next time, I want to wish you smooth seas.